Then we move into episode 3. Episode 3 is called Adam and Eva, or Adam und Eva. Mm-hmm. In this episode, we see old blind Tenhouse as a young boy with his father sometime in the past. His father carries a watch with the text for Charlotte in it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So apparently she died, and that's why he wants to build a time machine. We then see the unknown that kills old blind Tenhouse in like a carriage before he gets into the city where he's apparently planning on telling about the existence of travelers, of the time travelers. Then in 1888, we also see that Bartosz confronts Jonas with what older parallel Marta said about Adam, about mm-hmm. that he is Adam and that he killed Marta. Mm-hmm. Later, older parallel Marta shows stranger Jonas her time capsule and gives a marble of time travel matter to him to earn his trust.
Yeah, and also acts like the last one. That was funny.
Exactly. Yeah. So, nice. Stranger Jonas tries to create a blob. He seems to be successful, but then the blob disappears. At the same time, we see older parallel Marta escaping 8088 by using her time capsule with some of the other time travel marbles she has. Yeah. Then in parallel 2020, Ulrich ends his relationship with Charlotte after he found Mats in the forest. In the meantime, Hannah finds out that Ulrich cheats on her with Charlotte.
Again, with the sweater and the hair, yeah.
Exactly. Hannah blackmails Alexander Tiedemann at the plant, telling him that she wants him to destroy Charlotte.
Yeah.
All messed up triangle going on there.
Yeah. That woman is pretty much the whole general. Pretty messed up.
What we also see in parallel 2020 is that Helga arrives at the police station saying that he wants to make a statement telling that he was the one who did it, who killed Mats. Then Ulrich arrives and he points a finger at him. He's the one who did it. He is. Yeah. It was a bit confusing, but I think that was two different things he was talking about, I think.
Of course. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Then in 2053, older parallel Marta meets with Adam. He asks her if she gave it to him. It being the time travel matter she gave in 1888. Yeah. Adam tells her that she did the right thing. We see the blob. In the far future, Jonas is with Eva. She tells him that they are Adam and Eva and that they have to save both worlds. That they are endlessly connected with each other and that they are dark and light, and that if he wants Marta to live, he has to choose the light. After Jonas leaves Eva, Eva gets visited by the unknown. She tells him that Jonas, his Marta, has to die so that the others can live. They have to preserve the knot, and we see that Eva has the plans of the power plant. Quite a revelation already all here going on. Then we see at the end of this episode, we see Jonas meeting younger parallel Marta and telling her that he can show her that everything is connected. They go through the tunnels in the cave and get to the door. This door shows the text Erit Lux instead of Sigmundus Creatus Est. So Erit. Yeah, it has had a different, because it's of course the parallel world, so it had a different writing on it. Because this is more or less, of course, Eva's world, I would say. Mm-hmm. So this is, it has Erit Lux, and that means let there be light.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so they pass through the door and end up in some kind of wasteland. There's only sand there. A woman walks up to them and says, "Welcome to the future."
Exactly.
That was episode 3.
Yeah.
Any thoughts on episode 3 for you?
Yeah, you do a very good recap, because I remember it exactly like this now. For me, here started my frustration. two episodes I was very interested. And even if some things were really cool made and really intriguing, and a lot of moments you still didn't know what the hell was going on, but it was nice. And now in season of episode 3, the moment when Jonas meets with Eva in Eva's lair, and what started to really annoy me a bit, and that annoyed me before, but somehow I just put it aside, is that they only speak two words to each other a lot of times, or like one sentence, and they talk... especially Adam with Jonas, with Eva, and even like the group of friends like Franziska, Magnus, and Marta, a lot of times that there's so much shit going on. And if this happens to you, like, of course, it's the way that the makers make it. But it's so realistically made till this point that a realistic person, especially a young kid like Jonas, because he's in the show, he's supposed to be 18, I think, or something.
Yeah,
17?
Yeah, something like that, I guess.
Like that, I think. Like a young adolescent. And he went through hell. He was, like, hanged. And a lot of things happened to him. And then he ends up at this... they always tell him a different truth.
Yeah.
And they first his older self told him the truth. Then the Weiße Teufel told him the truth. And she said first that you thought the war was between the whites, which is the white devil, which is actually the good thing. And then you think Adam is bad. Then you think it's the other way around. And then now suddenly this third person comes, and which will show you that it's more between Adam and Eva. So that makes sense in a way. But for me, here it was already like, okay, but guys, we go now from three different things. We change every time. And you, as your watcher, you know, at least for me, I'm wondering what you think about it. I thought immediately Eva is lying, 100%. And I thought also, man, you don't ask more questions. You just stay there like, okay, now let's go. Let's do this again, you know?
Yeah.
So I felt like we don't, as a watcher, you don't get any answers, which is not a problem if you want to last until the end. And then the end is very good, and that's something we can debate later. What you think about it. But yeah, my frustration here started a bit, but it was too much of the same.
I get your point, and I also get your point, and I will get into that a bit later also. That maybe sometimes some writing was a bit too convenient. To hold things, but let's keep that fault. I think we will get back into it. But it's, I have to say, like the way you said it, I didn't experience that at that moment. It's not a fault that came with me. That I had something like, okay, why isn't he asking more questions?
Yeah.
The question I asked myself was, so apparently I was enough into the episode that I didn't ask myself that question for that matter. Mm-hmm. But I was still, after episode 3, I was unsure, where is this going? I think the line that I liked a lot applied here, and that is, what we know is a drop and what we don't know is an ocean. That's a bit how I felt here.
Yeah.
So I was getting a bit worried that there maybe might not be too much big revelations left anymore in the season.
No, my perspective was like, okay, guys, but what is it gonna be then?
I agree with you on that. That's what I also wrote down. I started worrying a bit, like, okay, it seems now that Adam and Eva really are Jonas and Martha. And that everything seems to be as it was more or less already a bit expected.
Yeah.
That the main plot is already quite given early in the season. I wrote down here that at this point I was still hoping for a huge plot twist. That it turns out that Jonas and Martha don't turn out to be Adam and Eva. Because I think...
Yeah, I also still hope for that. But yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, the first people ever. I had a bit the feeling like if they're really Adam and Eva, it maybe makes the story a bit too grand. But in the end, there's some things done that maybe undoes this a bit, but we'll talk about it later. But yeah, that was my feelings here. What I did feel like is that I, at one point during this episode, I was thinking like, damn, these creators, it is remarkable how they made every scene have a meaning and a function. Each scene pushes the plot forward. There's no...
Exactly. How do you keep up with it, first of all? How do you have to double check it every time?
Exactly. Yeah. So that's also, I get back into that at the end of, in my end review, the things I have to say about this season and this series maybe is a bit, how do you call it? Nitpicking, I think.
Yeah.
Because in the end, I think you also really have to admire, because this is not an easy story. And that's what I thought here. I had my faults, I had my doubts, but I also felt like, yeah, damn, they're really, this is not an easy job they're doing here.
Definitely not. Yeah.
Let us know in the comments what you thought of this season and the series as a whole. And if you liked this video, share your appreciation with us by hitting the like button and please subscribing to the channel.